This is Cry No More by Phonte.
At my ceiling fan, trying to be a man, wishing I had a chance to be his son first.
You know, it's crazy because, like, when I was a kid, my dad used to come pick me up from school. You know, he was an executive chef. That's what he did for a living. And, like, when he would bring me to the kitchen, I would be so excited to cook. You know, and he would be like, "Nah, you need to prep. You need to do preparation." And I didn't understand it at the time, but he was teaching me about life.
They asked me where I've been, dog. I've been rebuilding with my whiz and children. Put my pops in the ground, then hit the repass and ate the same shit that killed them. Your habits didn't deviate, just thought you would appreciate. My moms used to say I was a whore just like you. So, mom, I ran through even more just to spite you. And pop, my health is doing pretty good despite you. I try so I don't die at 54 just like you, cold. I'm one snowflake away from an avalanche. My first teachers were masters of self-sabotage. My mama walking slower these days, she got a stint. Still on them Newports, where's your fucking common sense? Pardon my French, I'm just still unconvinced. That as young as you are, soon I'll be taking care of you. I get it, you're the one who did the raising, I'm the son. But I'm not ready to cry at your Lorraine hands bury you. You can't undo it, you either succumb to it. Make the adjustment or just become numb to it. Looking over your life like, what have I done to it? Knowing your bloodline is the river that runs through it. My sons look at me these days and think I'm certified. Preparing them for a world they'll be deserted by. Internalized black man, if you get a teaspoon of compassion, that's more than double the serving size. I get impatient, shit is taking too long. They don't get it, I really lived it. You can say what you want, cause by the time you realize that your father was right, you probably have your own son telling you that you wrong. But be his ride or die, even if you two ain't seeing eye to eye. Teach him how to throw a punch, ride a bike, tie a tie, hold on to him while you can. This is just what I advise.
All right. But anyway, okay, so that is Cry No More by Phonte. And I actually was like, I came across that track because I think I had one of my playlists on and I heard another song from this album. And that made me go back to the album and see, all right, what are some other gems that I've been sleeping on? And I was just going through it and this song came on. And, you know, the first verse is kind of like, all right, I hear it. But then the second verse, yeah, it started to hit. And then I thought about you. So with that, I want you to go through some of the thoughts that you were having as you were listening to that track.
I mean, some of the things that I wrote down was just mentorship, black men, misguided, hood living, working father, no plan, education, and just fatherhood. It was just some random things that I put down. But just listening to the track, and he had mentioned in kind of that monologue that was going on where that father was an executive chef and brought him into the kitchen and stuff and talked about preparation, mm-hmm, and how he said he didn't know what that meant, but still he still remembered it. He didn't say how old he was. I don't think he said how old he was, but I'm assuming, right, that he was a kid. But yeah, a lot of the lessons that you learn as a kid, you really don't know what they mean until you're like 30, you know, sometimes. So
the part that caught, I'm glad you gathered that. It was a couple parts. So I thought about generational curses because there's one part where he, yep, talks about how I ate the same thing that you ate that, yep, led to your early grave, and how he talks about how, you know, I realized by the time I realized that you were right, I have a son that's telling me, no, you're not right.
Yeah.
So I wanted you to kind of touch on, what does that mean to you?
No, that's big for me, the mention of the food. So, you know, I like soul food just like everybody else. But I literally was just going to write a status on this the other day. One of the things that was passed down to me from my parents as a whole was healthy eating, man.
Mm.
I mean, forget the money, mm-hmm, forget, you know, college plan and all that other stuff. You don't have health, I mean, you're not going to last that long out there.
Mm-hmm.
And my parents, my dad was basically a personal trainer before it was a thing. Like, cool, our living room was literally weights.
Yeah.
I didn't have a couch in our living room. We had a weight bench, squat rack, and a floor model TV. My dad literally used to make us walk everywhere. He really believed that a car was just only if you need it. So we would go grocery shopping. It'd be a family of four walking 2 miles to go grocery shopping.
Wow.
Or riding our bikes. Like, we rode our bikes everywhere. We walked everywhere. My dad was really into, like, being active and staying active and stuff. Snacks and stuff like that in the house. my parents controlled it. They had it in their room underneath the TV. There was like an armoire that you can open up and there was a drawer in there. But I had to go through, you know, my parents' room to get it.
Yeah.
So, but fruit and vegetables would be abundant.
Readily available.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that really got me into a space of understanding just fruit as a whole and like not having it as like a punishment or, you know, so it was really what I identified as a snack for a long time. Not to say that I still wouldn't have candy and stuff, but now that I'm older, I really appreciated that because even now I'll buy a bag of sugar and that joint will last me 4, 5, 6, 7 years, man.
Wow.
Yeah, I don't even really eat sugar.
Yeah.
A lot of my family's like, oh, he doesn't. I mean, I still eat, you know, quote unquote, the soul food, the bad foods that are out there, fried food. I just don't prepare it at my house. I'll go out and buy it. I'll go and get a Permani sandwich. I'll go get some chicken wings and stuff like that. But I don't really prepare those things in my house. I think that's a... that's something that we really miss the boat on sometimes, man, in the Black community, because I mean, I don't know if people know this, but some of us, we just have these natural body types, right?
Yeah.
And if you just take care of it, I mean, you can age gracefully, man.
Right.